Hi, I'm Josh Bloom. Welcome to another video in the RSP Supply Education Series. If you find that these videos are helpful to you, it certainly helps us out if you could give us a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. In today's video, we are going to be talking about the use of emergency stop devices to cut power to different kinds of machinery like motors, cutters, conveyors, and other common industrial equipment. More specifically, we are going to be referencing the ISO 13850 standard or e-stop function and look at two different e-stop categories that exist to find out about when you might use one or the other and why. I'm talking about the category 0 e-stop function and the category 1 e-stop function. Again, for the purpose of this video, we will look at the basic differences between these two functions and see why one function might be preferred over the other based on the various risk assessments you might make for your specific application. As always, the information shared in this video is intended to provide only a basic overview of this topic and should never take the place of proper electrical instruction. With that being said, let's take a closer look at these two different ways you can perform an e-stop function and learn more about how they work and why these standards are used. Before we get too far into these two different categories, let's first briefly talk about why you might want to have an e-stop circuit in the first place. It may seem obvious, but an e-stop is used when you need to have the ability to cut power to potentially dangerous hardware that can exist in many different areas. The e-stop provides a very simple, safe, and fast way to cut power and stops the function of hardware such as motors, cutters, conveyors, and other common industrial equipment. This stop function should occur without causing any additional unsafe conditions. These e-stop circuits are typically used with safety-rated hardware such as safety relays. This safety-rated hardware provides added levels of assurance that the stop function will work as intended with no issues. The level of safety that is provided is dictated by the amount of risk that is present in a given area. Once a risk assessment has been completed, you can decide what type of hardware to use to enable the safest work environment possible. Along with this risk assessment, you might determine that you want the machinery to behave in different ways once the stop is actuated. This is where different e-stop categories might come into play. A stop category 0 function works by immediately killing power to hardware that it is connected to. This is the fastest and safest way to provide a safe stop function for an e-stop safety circuit. It should be noted that additional electrical or mechanical actions may still occur to more quickly provide a safe environment, such as braking. However, there are situations when the e-stop might be actuated, but the power is not immediately shut off. There is a delay of the mechanical disconnect. This is a category 1 stop function. This function is common when it is necessary for a certain process to finish its movement or cycle or to wind down before it is safe to shut power. This category is also used when cutting power immediately can actually create a more dangerous environment for the operators in the area of the equipment in question. By allowing for a delay to occur, it provides time for machinery to safely shut down. Again, this is all dependent on your specific scenario and the type of hardware that is being used. This is why it is so important to perform a proper risk assessment for your circuit and know exactly how a stop function will need to behave. Understanding both categories of e-stop functions will allow you to be more prepared for situations where you need to provide this function for your own specific application. Make sure to always reference local codes and guidelines and seek the help of a qualified person to ensure your system functions safely and as expected. For a full line of safety-rated e-stops, as well as thousands of other products, please go to our website. For more information or other educational videos, go to rspsupply.com, the internet's top source for industrial hardware. Also, don't forget, like and subscribe.